shouldn't that opening song be "Time keeps on spinning, spinning into the future"? Not slipping. Hey, Tortoise, hurry up, will ya?
Coming.
How can you be late for our big show? It's about time!
Listen, Hare, who won the race?
Oh, no, not this again. I told you, I pulled a hamstring. I was groggy that day.
Take it easy. Enjoy the moment. Smell the roses.
Smell the roses? I'm a robot. Come on! Cool clock contraption, Tortoise. Is that a time machine?
Yeah, sort of. Me and my science friends built it. To tell this story about time, we need to take our time. Patience, my friend.
Awesome! A portal to other worlds? Other dimensions?
Yes, yes. We're going to explore time. All the cosmic cycles humans live by. From the Earth's rotation to time dilation.
Time dilation? What's that?
All in good time. Step over here. Keep your eye on that big clock.
When do we go? How do we go? Where do we go?
Calm your circuit. There's no time like the present.
Wild.
Our story starts with the world's very first timekeeper, the sun.
But the sun's not moving. The Earth is spinning once every 24 hours.
You're very smart, Hare. We'll get to that soon. But first, humans. By simply tracking shadows, measured time. The first sundial was found in Egypt. Watch the moving shadow. It comes from that stick or pole. That's called a gnomon. Gnomon means to know. As the sun moves across the sky, the shadow moves across the sundial. These markers represent hours. It was the Egyptians who created the 24-hour day.
A shadow clock. Genius!
We need to head back to the time lab. I have a few adjustments to make before our next trip. There. That should fix it.
What's up? Where to next?
We're heading to space, the final frontier.
Where no rabbit robot has been before! Cool! Like I said, the Earth spins day and night, day and night. One spin equals 24 hours. You can sure make time fly out here.
Actually, the Earth spins every 23 hours and 56 minutes with respect to the stars. That's called a sidereal day.
What? I thought the day is 24 hours.
That's called a solar day. It's different than the sidereal day. To understand their disparity, let's widen our view.
Nice! I see the Earth is spinning and orbiting the Sun. One orbit equals 1 year. Another major cosmic cycle for all those humans down there. 1 year equals 365.25 days. But no matter how you slice it, 1 day is still 24 hours long.
Maybe these kids can help show you the difference between the sidereal day and the solar day. If you face the sun and spin once and don't orbit the sun, you get a certain time, right?
Yeah.
That's the sidereal day. But now, if you spin once again, but this time you move around the sun at the same time, you have to spin a little more to face the sun directly again. It takes you a little more time. That is the solar day.
Okay, think I got it. The Earth orbits the Sun, and it needs another 4 minutes to complete its spin, so it faces the Sun straight on. Ha ha! What else you got, old tortoise, wise fountain of knowledge?
Ready for another wrinkle in time?
Sure, I got all the time in the world.
The Earth, well, the entire solar system, revolves around the center of the Milky Way galaxy, a vast collection of 200 billion stars, give or take. One trip takes 227 million years. And that's traveling at 137 miles per second, or 4.3 billion...
Time out, Tortoise. We need some downtime. All your crazy big numbers, no one understands them.
Okay, okay. You're right, Hare. Best I explain big numbers in my cosmic chill room.
Cosmic chill room?
This is my spacey place, where I relax, slow down, use my imagination. I'm a tortoise. It suits me.
Okay, trippy abode. But I want to know about big numbers. You said you'd explain.
All right. Check out this clock. How long do you think a million seconds is? No Googling.
No idea. Let's see. 60 seconds in a minute, 60 minutes in an hour.
Just guess, you robot rabbit.
I don't know. Maybe a day?
The answer is 12 days. Almost. Now, use this clock. Guess how long a billion seconds is.
Without any computer assistance, I'd say, 24 days?
Try 32 years.
That's mind-boggling, even for a robot. A million and a billion are not even close to being the same number.
One last cosmic clock question. How long is a trillion seconds?
Oh, I'm toast. What's the answer?
32,000 years.
Inconceivable! All right, enough of your cosmic chill room. Can we go back to exploring space and time, please? We're back in space, all right. Now I see the moon.
The moon orbits the Earth once every...
month! A month was called a moonth by the humans long, long time ago.
The moon orbits the Earth every 27.3 days with respect to the stars. That's a sidereal month.
Oh no, not this again. Let's see, the Earth is moving too, like we saw before, so the lunar month is longer, right?
Very good, Hare. Not so harebrained after all. The more familiar lunar or synodic month equals 29.5 days. Since the Earth moves around the Sun, the Moon needs another 2.2 days to complete its phases, or the time to go from one full moon to the next full moon.
Wait a sec. 29.5 days would mean there can be two full moons in the same month?
Humans call the second full moon the blue moon, but it doesn't turn blue.
A blue moon means there can be 13 full moons in a year, but a year has 12 months, or moons, not 13. What gives, my wise tortoise friend?
You have detected an ancient conundrum. When you divide the solar cycle, 365.25 days, by the lunar cycle, 29.5 days, you get 12.38 months.
Is this why months are so irregular? Having 30 or 31 days? Or weird February with its 28 days?
Yup. Time for a change. Let's explore the origins for the 7 days of the week. The 7 days of the week come from the seven objects that move in the sky: the sun, moon, and five visible planets. Of course, today, humans know the sun doesn't really move.
I get sun for Sunday. Monday must be moon day. Oh, and Saturn for Saturn day. But what's up with Tuesday?
For the answer, we need to see these seven orbs as seven ancient gods. Tuesday comes from 2, the Anglo-Saxon name for Tyr, the Norse god of war. To the Romans, the god of war is Mars. In Spanish, Tuesday is Martes. Wednesday matches Odin or Woden. In Norse mythology, he is the supreme deity. The Roman god for Wednesday is Mercury. Wednesday is miércoles in Spanish. Thursday originates from Thor.
The mighty Thor! He's pretty powerful, strongest Avenger. So Thursday is Thor Day.
Oh, like it.
Settle down, young rabbit. Thor is a Norse god. His Roman counterpart is Jupiter, the king of the gods. In Greek, he's called Zeus. Friday, for the Norse god Freya, representing love and beauty. Her Roman complement is Venus. In Spanish, Friday is Viernes. In Greek, she is Aphrodite. Saturday stems from the Roman god Saturn, the god of wealth, agriculture, and time. The Greeks called this god Kronos. Sunday comes from Sol, the Roman god of the sun. Think solar system. The Greek sun god is known as Helios and sometimes Apollo. And finally, Monday, the English translation of Luna, Roman goddess of the moon. She is also called Diana. Selene is her Greek counterpart. There, the 7 days of the week, the 7 objects that move in the sky.
Can you please warn me when we go through that portal thing?
Sorry about that. Have to change settings so we can travel to Babylonia to visit a ziggurat. Let's explore the origins for minutes and seconds.
That's a ziggurat? It's like an Egyptian pyramid.
Our story of minutes and seconds starts with the ancient ziggurat of Ur, built over 4,000 years ago. But it was only 400 years ago when humans started using 60 minutes and 60 seconds. The ancient Babylonians. Their number system was not based on the number 10, but on their circle and number 60.
Why 60?
Its exact origins are fuzzy. But it is thought the Babylonians came up with the 360-degree circle because of the 365 days in a year.
360, 365, I get it.
And a cool thing about the number 360 is the fact it's easily divisible by 24 different numbers.
Look at all of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I get it. People kept using the Babylonian circle over and over, and it eventually led to the 60 minutes in an hour and the 60 seconds in a minute.
Hey, Hare. Did you know there are units of time based on human hands and not the sky above?
Say what?
Time for the big time. Check out my big-time top 10 list. Number 10. Humans have 10 fingers.
Counting their 2 thumbs.
Number 9. These fingers match the 10 digits humans count with.
I get it! Humans like to count in groups of 10. Ooh! Can I read the next one? Number 8. A decade equals 10 years. 7. A century equals 100 years. 6. A millennium is 1,000 years. Wait, that's only 6? What's longer than a millennium?
Number 5. Geologic epochs vary, but they're over a million years long. 4. A period is a unit of time that combines successive epochs. 3. An era consists of distinct periods. 2. An eon equals the combination of comparable eras.
What's number 1 on your big time top 10 list?
Number 1. The age of the universe is 13.8 billion years.
Give or take.
That's the longest time we know of.
So far.
Cool top 10 list, Tortoise. Where to next?
Downtime. I need to chill again. My tortoise sensors need to recharge.
Back to your funky room. Is this your remote?
Go ahead.
Super! Dinosaurs! Time-wise, they lived millions of years ago, right?
Correct. From 250 to 66 million years ago, the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous periods, or the Mesozoic era.
You sure know your time.
Did you know when dinosaurs ruled, the days were about 23 hours long?
What? Not 24? What's slowing down the Earth's spin?
The moon, mostly. Its gravitational force and the transfer of angular momentum.
Transfer of angular momentum?
Yes. The moon and Earth have been pulling on each other for over 4 billion years. The moon slows the Earth's spin, and the Earth speeds up the moon's orbit, causing it to move faster and spiral away from the Earth.
Crazy!
When the Earth was born, it spun once every 4 hours. Billions of years from now, one day will equal 50 hours.
Time sure works wonders.
Sure does. But we are almost out of time, and we have one more stop. Ready?
Where are we going?
The future. Time for Einstein time.
Didn't he live a long time ago, not the future?
Yes, over 100 years ago. Einstein's equation said, the faster you go, the slower time passes, compared to someone who is stationary or not moving.
I heard of that. It's called time dilation.
Correct. Say you have two people, twins. One takes off on a long space trip, traveling near the speed of light. The other stays at home. Einstein showed a couple things in his theories of relativity. First, the laws of physics are the same for everyone. If the twin on the spaceship drops her space cup, it falls straight down. If the twin at home drops her cup, it falls straight down too.
Makes sense.
Second, Einstein proved nothing can go faster than the speed of light. 186,000 miles per second.
That's weird. You're saying both twins experience light at the same speed, no matter how fast they're moving toward it or away from it.
If light speed doesn't change, then other things have to, like
time!
Bingo! Time ticks at different rates for these twins
when they compare their clocks because they're not moving at the same speed relative to each other.
We definitely see her clock running slower compared to her twin's clock back on Earth. Her long Star Trek is finally over. She is now younger than her twin.
Shocking!
Time to hit the road, Hare.
Can you imagine if humans ever do travel near light speed? I can picture it. The Anti-Aging Travel Agency. We sure had an adventure through time.
And all the cosmic cycles humans live by.
Thanks, Tortoise. Hey, I just thought of something. Human beings get a birthday every time they complete a trip around the sun. This means they travel 600 million miles every birthday at almost 20 miles a second.
It's about time.
It's about time for what? Another adventure?
Sorry, it's the end of our journey. Time's up.
Oh, okay, I guess. Hate for it to end, but you're right. Let the end credits roll.
Keeps on slipping. Spinning, rotating, orbiting, expanding into the future. Time keeps on.
Oh, hey, Tortoise! You didn't cover the expansion of time from the Big Bang!
Another time.
Oh, and you should do more on sundials, too, and water clocks, and cuckoo clocks.
Don't make me say it.
And what about using stars to tell time? Constellations?
I think it's high time for the lights to come up.
Timely idea.
Why don't you thank everyone for coming to the show?
Thanks, everyone. Hope you had a whale of a time. Sorry, I lose track of time so much. I get pressed for time, and then, I run out of time. When I'm the first place in the